Welcome to Celebrating Act Two.
This is another one of our reviews of the Vintage Film Channel. Great place for classic TV and film.
And today, John and I are going to talk about one of the early sitcoms, My Little Margie, which was on the air from 52 to 55 or thereabouts. And I think there was a total of about, 100 episodes.
Yeah, it was very popular. It's a primetime sitcom. Art, did you tell me that it was on both, on two networks?
Yeah, actually, I did a little research. It was one of my favorites, Cute as a Button and Gale Storm. Yeah. And I'm thinking of another one, which we'll talk about in later weeks, Gale Storm. And it had a father, and it had a normal cast of characters that you would normally get on any sitcom. And it was a good, fun humor at the time.
Yeah. Yeah. It was one of the big hits of the 50s. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So do you remember which episode you watched on Vintage Film Channel?
Yeah. So I watched number 44. It's not okay. Like Friends, you know, the one where Rachel did this or the one that Joey did that. Okay. And maybe there were some titles, but this one was number 44.
Just number 44. Yeah. I watched the one. It was called something like a new, what's the boyfriend's name in sitcom?
Freddie Wilson. The new boyfriend, though. Yeah. Okay.
So anyway, it was about him being a new guy.
Right.
It was a very cute plot.
Yeah. But again, mine was about the hapless boyfriend, Freddie Wilson, who was always unemployed, and the father, Vern Albright, Gale Storm's father. Played by a guy named Charles Farrell, by the way, who was disapproving of him.
He was a famous character actor.
Yeah, he was. He was a big name. I don't know what Gale Storm did before that, but this was definitely her highlight of her career, for sure. But anyway, it was a hapless boyfriend and the father who's disapproving, and then for some reason he starts approving a little bit when he thinks there could be an advantage, and then things go awry. And yeah, I'm sure it's not too different from the episode that you watched.
Yeah, you know, it's the thing about sitcoms, quite frankly, is even today, they have to have the same cast of characters every week. They have to get into trouble, and they have to solve it, and they have to make you laugh all the way through.
Right.
And it doesn't matter what it is they do, because it's always silly stuff, and it always gets resolved, and everybody always laughs. And yeah, that's true of My Little Margie.
I have to admit, okay, that it'd be great if you go out and watch a couple of episodes, and I'm still going to watch a few more, but I must have been between the ages 8 and 10, 8 and 11 during the prime time that I watched it, and it's dated, but it's fun. It's good, pure, clean fun.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. That almost anybody could watch. You wouldn't say your kid can't watch it because there's a little romance in there or something like that. It wasn't more serious subjects, let's say, that you would find on Friends or Seinfeld and things like that. But it was good, clean, fun.
The episode that I watched was pretty typical in the sense that the boyfriend, the father hates the boyfriend, doesn't hate him, but he would really
disapprove.
Why is my daughter wasting time with him?
Right.
So his boss, Mr. Honeywell, gives him the idea to, in order to alienate the boyfriend from Margie, the father, Vern, takes the kid aside and says, you know, you really need to be a man, not a mouse. You know, women love a strong, a dominant male. So, of course, the kid takes his advice. And Margie, knowing the father knows that Margie will react negatively to it, then Margie reacts negatively, grabs him by the tie and says, what do you think you're doing? And she figures it out. So she and the boyfriend get together and turn the tables on the father. And the father starts tearing his hair out. Oh, my God, they're going to get engaged. It backfired on me. And then, of course, it flips back and forth three or four times. And while the production is old-fashioned and the jokes are kind of lame, it's still funny. It's still the same kind of sitcom that you watch today, this silly mix-ups.
Think of it as a less than polished I Love Lucy.
Yes.
Yeah. Who has a pretty lame thing. But you know what? It was great entertainment. But yep. For me, you know that I like to do, I find other things to look for also. So I looked up Honeywell and Todd, and I found out I never remember having seen the partner Todd, the company, the investment firm that Vern Albright, Margie's father, worked for. But there really was a Todd who did appear from time to time. Honeywell
was... got into the trivia, huh?
Yeah. And the fact that it was on CBS and NBC going back and forth, I don't know how all that worked out.
Yeah.
But Freddie Wilson was the son of a famous Hollywood personality.
That's interesting.
Good-looking kid. And Gale Storm. Wait, hold on one second. Her name, because Gale Storm does, in fact, sound theatrical, as they gave people in those days, was Josephine Cottle.
Who?
Josephine Cottle. That is a birth name.
I think Gale Storm was an improvement to Josephine.
Right. Although today, that would have been fine.
You're right. Things are different today. But you know what? What I enjoyed about it, I enjoyed the actors, the characters. Her father, a pretty famous character actor in his own right, and the guy who played Mr. Honeywell, the father's boss, is another name, another character that I'd seen in movies.
Yeah.
I didn't know who Margie was. I still don't know where she came from. Not like Bob Hope, who had been in vaudeville and got his own TV show. But she was awfully cute. And what struck me was how times have changed. She's always in a really cute feminine dress. The boyfriend always seems to have a tie and jacket on.
Right.
And, you know, today is so much more casual. Compare that, just the way they were dressed, to Friends, as an example, sitcom of today. So it's a lot of fun to look back at the way things were, but the humor is the same, I think. It's a little slower humor, but you still get a couple of kicks out of it.
But it was really nice, and I'm looking forward to looking at some of these other sitcoms, which Vintage Film Channel has plenty of them.
Right.
Is that it's a nice way to take a look at the past.
Yep.
And while it might not be today's genre, okay, it was the early sitcom, and it filled a place of happiness the once a week that it was on. And this one had very high Nielsen ratings, and apparently I can't find any reason why it was canceled, because it had very high ratings, and it just maybe the actors got tired of it. So I'm not interested in going into that kind of detail, but... In any event, if for us vintage film people and vintage TV people, these are, if you want to go back and see what made you happy then, and give you a good chuckle and a laugh today.
Yeah, we'll go back and look at what your parents thought was great primetime television.
Right. Yeah. Parents, us.
It's a vintage film channel. On YouTube. / Vintage Film Channel.
Right.
That's where we saw it. And you click on the playlist, and the playlist will open up, you know, hundreds of videos for you. And then look for My Little Margie, and I don't know how many episodes there are, but they're all fun.
Yeah.
They're all good to go. And then also, be sure to go to vintagefilmchannel.com, which is a community site, pay site. Get merchandise, stuff like that. Both are great places to see all those old films and old TV shows.
Okay, and by the way, if you want to prove yourself to be very popular with your grandkids as a real old fuddy-duddy, bring them to one of these channels.
Yeah.
Bring them to something that made you happy, because they don't know anything except going, you know, on their devices.
They should be watching My Little Margie.
They should be. They should be, and they'd grow up to be perfect people like we are.
We'll see you soon for another review of the Vintage Film Chat.
For more on Celebrating Act Two, visit our webpage, follow us on Facebook, subscribe to us on YouTube, and tell your friends. Celebrating Act Two is the user manual for the second half of your life.